everyone. Today in this video, we are going to create a translator app which will translate a sentence or a text in the language that the user has selected. We will also add a list viewer component so that the viewer can choose the language from the list. And remember, we are making this app, this translator app, on Thunkable. So first of all, we have to simply click on create new app and name the project. So let's say translator 100. So then we will click on the create button. After clicking on create, you will see a screen like this. Now here we are going to work the design and the blocks. In blocks we will do the blocking, and in the design we will design all the components. And more importantly, in this app there will be two screens. The number one is going to be the splash screen, so let's just name the screen so that way we know what exactly this screen does. And the another screen will be, so let's add it, the working screen. So let's name it working screen. So we got two screens. Now we will work on the first screen later on, but first let's start with the second screen, that is the working screen. Now for that, let's choose a good color for it. Say I think green will be much better. Okay, then in this there will be two labels, one and two. Let's name them. Okay, so the screen label number two will be named as invisible label. Now I tell you why, but before that let's just name that invisible label. And the another one is going to be named as the say select language label. Select label. Okay, so these are the two labels. Then we are going to add a button and a text input. Now let's go ahead with the button. Now button will be font size, let's take 20 or 25, color to be a purple, a little bit dark, and in the text it will be written translate or translate rest. Translate, great. And then straight down we will make its radius 0, and also we will increase its height. So relative size 10. Okay, that's good. Now let's go ahead with the text input. Now in the text input we are going to just remain its same type here, and then we are going to change its height to relative size to be 30. Great. So we are almost done with the designing. Let's add one more component here, list viewer. List viewer will be invisible right here, and let's modify it and make them up and downs. So the label number, invisible label, will be on the topmost, and the list viewer will be down. And let's add a little bit space also. For the label, we will go to the margin and change the margins for it. So I have chosen 20 for the bottom for all of these so that it will add a little bit space between them. Now in the invisible label, the one which is the invisible label, there will be nothing written in it, so that is why it is we have named it invisible label. Next, let's add some of the invisible components here. That is a translator, text to speech, so whatever results will come it will speak it. And another that we want to add is the local DBI. So these are the three invisible components that we have added. Now, the only thing in the design that we need to do is to go on to the local DBI1 and then click to edit data table in the properties, and then here we are going to write all the languages, and we are also going to name the heading of the columns. So let's add a field for them. One is the column one will be the translate, and column two will be the text to speech. Next, another important thing that we are going to do is, for example, here I write Russian. Okay, Russian. So that means whatever language we write in the translator column, the same will be written into the text to speech column also. And like this, we have to add all the 100 languages, and then we will go on to the blocking. So let's add. So now I have listed most of the languages that we want to. So after doing this, we are done all with the design. Now the only thing left is the blocking. Now for this, we first of all need a variable here. Initialize app variable name to be language. Okay, language 2, and this will be left empty. Now then we are going to go on to the screen number 2 that we have named as working screen. When working screen starts, go to the control, if, then to the logic, if equals to, but here we will leave it as not equals to, and then again going to the variables role, and then app variable language not equals to, then to the logic and null, and then from the select language label, here's the select language label. From select language label, go to the local DB1, call get cell, and then we will here take a text, and then again we are just, let's make a duplicate of it, and then we are going to stick it here, and here we are going to write translator. Yes, translator. And then we are going to go on to the translator number 1 and set and drag this out. Set translator 1 target language, and then we are going to make it a duplicate and just stick it here. And then we are going to the list viewer. From the list viewer, we are going to take the invisible. Set list viewer. Text items to, again we will stick this here to local DBI get cell, but here there is a condition, we will change it to get cell, so here app variable will be gone, and the only thing here left is the translator, so not get cell but get column here. Then again going to the select language, and when clicked again, then go to the list viewer, visible one, and set visibility to true. And then again going to this one and drag this one out, item click. Then I have taken from the select language label this one, and from the list viewer, visibility. Now here the label will be, select label will be then to the item, and the list viewer will be visible as false, and the index will come as set app variable language to index, and then we are going to make its duplicate and set it right here, and then we will go on to the text to speech and set the text to speech, and then copy it here again, and then we will go to the button one, that is the translate button. When this is clicked, go to the call translator, and then from the text input take this out and stick it here, and then I have take from the invisible label and call text to speech speak, and then we will put the result here. So we are done with the blocking. Now this completes our app. Let's live test it. Thank you for watching.